Hello friends, today I will talk on spurious hemoptysis or pseudohemoptysis. Patient complains of hemoptysis, but actually the patient is not having hemoptysis. In this condition, what happens is patient is anxious, patient's family member, they get anxious, and ultimately a improper history to the doctor is presented. And it will affect the doctor's decision, doctor investigation strategy and treatment strategy. So this is very important to know what is actual hemoptysis or real hemoptysis, what is not. Today I'll talk on that. So let's start, friends. Hemoptysis is defined as coughing out of blood when the source of blood is lower respiratory tract. But in case of pseudohemoptysis, usually the bleeding is above the larynx. I'll tell you five causes when the pseudohemoptysis occurs. The first one is blood coming from oral cavity near pharynx, etc. Sometimes from the tongue also. So this is the first one. Second is aspiration from hematemesis. If the patient is having hematemesis, then sometime patient aspirate that blood, and then the patient coughs out that blood. So patient present history of hemoptysis, and patient tells that I am coughing out of blood. Actually, that blood has come from hematemesis. The origin is hematemesis, or the origin is stomach. The third one is sometimes colonization by red pigment forming bacteria like Serratia marcescens. It gives rise to coloration of sputum. Usually the patient who has received a broad spectrum antibiotic for a long time or on ventilatory support, this type of patient, they develop this infection. The fourth one is oxidation of bronchodilator inside the mouth give rise to some brown pigment like thing, and it gives the color to the sputum. And the last one is self-inflicting injuries or malingering. So these are all the causes of pseudohemoptysis. I hope you have liked this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and click the like button and share this video with your family and friends. Thank you for watching.